All right, in this lesson, we're going to be looking at the multiple step income statement. So prior to this point, we've actually hinted to the multiple step income statement. Actually, you saw a multiple step income statement in this section, but here we're going to kind of solidify that multiple step income statement for, especially for manufacturers. Although it is not required for service companies do use it because it does give very good insight to some of the information that an external user would want to see in a financial statement. So we're going to take a look here. I'm just going to walk you through the multiple step income statement. I'm not really going to show you how to create one. I think if you see it and I point some things out, you could duplicate this without actually going through an example. So let's take a look at a multiple step income statement. Now, the context of the income statement is that it reflects the financial results of a company during a given period of time. So we say that income statement shows the results of a given time period, usually annually, but sometimes could be quarterly or monthly. At a minimum for public companies, it's annually as well as quarterly. So it is quarterly, but we want to get to the annual report, which is annually. So every year reporting income for the company as well as expenses for that company. Now, prior to this point in your accounting studies, we have been looking at a single step income statement. Now, what makes it single? Well, what makes it single is here. We've got all of our revenues and then all of our expenses. And then we take revenues minus expenses and we get net income and we are done. So we group all of our ins, revenues, and all of our outs, expenses. Now, we haven't talked about gains or losses, but we would also take those gains and losses and put them in their respective section. So gains would go with revenues, losses would go with expenses. So a single step just has one step, revenues, then down step to expenses. In this lesson, we are talking about the multiple income statement, so we're going to change this up a little bit. So I just want to make sure that you have a picture of what this looks like. Revenues, then expenses. Now, for manufacturers and merchandisers, the way we prepare income statements can provide more useful information to users. Now, for manufacturers and merchandisers, a multi-step income statement can provide more and better information for users. And a lot of this has to do with efficiency of the financial statement. So sure, we can use a single step for a merchandiser and a manufacturer, but the problem is there isn't that efficiency, and we want the efficiency of the person who's reading it. We want to give them gross profit, which is kind of where this comes from. We want to give them the gross profit number without having that person on the other end have to calculate gross profit, because we know that everybody would be calculating gross profit. So if everybody's going to be calculating gross profit, why don't we just give them gross profit? Well, that's what we use a multiple income step statement to do. So if you notice here, we've got a copy of a pretend multi-step income statement. And if you notice here, look, we've got an in, and then we have an out, and then we have some more outs, and then we have some outs, and then I don't show it here, but we may have a couple more ins, and then we have an out. So notice how we've got different steps here, and not everything is grouped into one ins and one's out. So if you notice here, we've got sales revenue, and then we've got minus cost of goods sold to get us gross profit. So we're already giving you an intermediate step right here. The intermediate step is gross profit. So we're not even summarizing the rest of the expenses. We're just stopping it here and giving you a number that gross profit for this company was $5,000 for the year. Then from there, we take another step, and another step would be all of your operating expenses. So notice we've got wages expense, advertising expense, internet expense. Then we sum that out to get to total operating expenses. Then from there, we get to income from operations. Well, that income from operations is based on the step above it and then the step above that. 5,000 minus 2,225 gets us 2,775. Then from there, we've got another step, and this would be other expenses that wouldn't be considered operating or cost of goods sold. So in this case, we have other expenses, income before income tax, and then we've got income tax expense and net income. So notice how we have multiple steps, multiple calculations to get to the net income. The net income technically speaking, would be the same on a single step as a multiple step. The only difference here being that we are going to kind of categorize expenses by what they are, as well as how do they actually affect the income statement for the company. Now, if you're an investor, you want to know what that gross profit number is, because you want to know from the onset, if they're selling goods to the public, are they making money on that piece alone? Because if they're not, that means that the company's buying the inventory at one price and selling it for a price lower than they bought it. That gross profit number is important because we don't want companies to do that. We want them to buy low, sell high. Buy the product low, mark it up, and sell it high. That's what we're trying to do at the end of the day. And so that's why that gross profit number is so important. And that's one of the reasons why we like this multiple step. We want to see that. We don't have to calculate it. Okay. And then we want to see some other segments of the income and expenses. And I don't have any other income. I should have put some other income here so you can see it, but I just didn't. But you might have other income that would come like right here. I could put other income right here, or income, interest revenue from like a bank deposit. Interest revenue would go there. And notice we're really mixing up the ins and outs of this financial statement. So this is a multiple step income statement. The key thing here that you should know is we always start with sales revenues, then we go to cost of goods sold, then we go to gross profit. From gross profit, then we go all the way down to get to our net income. So for manufacturers and merchandises, the key with multiple step income statement is that we segregate the core operations of revenue and expenses from every other activity. This allows us to immediately see what generates regular income versus non-regular income. So that is a look at the multiple step income statement. Again, it's really just like what we've talked about before with the single step, except we're segregating it a little bit more in this statement to make it more usable to the user of the financial statement. So hope you enjoyed this lesson. We'll see you in the next video. Hey guys, if you like this video, make sure you press the like button below. And if you're looking for worksheets that go along with all of these lessons, head over to my website at patrickleemsa.com or click in the link in the far right. And I've got your next lesson right over here. So just click that link and it'll take you to that video. So until then, we'll see you in the next lesson.